Prince Harry has ensured he is part of the Climate Health Action Plan with a new event as the royal family make waves during COP26. Now, Prince Harry has made sure he is part of the climate change plan after welcoming delegates of the Centre for Compassion and Altruism Research and Education, CCARE, into a conversation about climate change. CCARE tweeted, "Prince Harry, the Duke of Sussex, welcomed realizing a compassionate planet delegates to a conversation related to climate health and mental health, facilitated by Dr. James Doty." Richard Eden claimed the 37-year-old prince and his wife Meghan Markle would have hated not being present at COP26 due to the high-profile platform it offers. In a recorded video message for world leaders, the Queen praised her son Prince Charles and her grandson Prince William for their contribution to the climate debate and their environmental activism. Speaking of Harry's response on the Mail Plus podcast Palace Confidential, diary editor Richard Eden said, "They will have hated not being at COP26, I mean just the chance to talk to the whole world with Prince William there. One thing, in the Queen's speech, which I think will have been genuinely hurtful for Harry was no reference to him. The Queen talked about how her husband's environmental concerns were being built on by his son Prince Charles and his grandson Prince William. No mention of Harry, even though the environment is something that he's felt very strongly about through the years, has spoken about and he's even launched initiatives like Travelist to try and do something for the environment. So I think that will have been hard for him." Over the years, the Duke of Sussex has launched a number of initiatives tackling the climate crisis, and has previously described it as one of the world's two most pressing issues. Despite not directly joining the meeting, Prince Harry and Meghan Markle had announced their commitment to finding solutions for our climate crisis, a day after the Queen snubbed them in her COP26 speech. A statement was released on their Archul website, in which the foundation is so inspired by the couple's long-standing commitment to the planet, both together and prior to their union, that they have committed to cut its carbon emissions over the next several years. Achieving net zero carbon emissions means making a series of choices over time to make that footprint as small as possible, while compensating for any remaining emissions through high-quality carbon removal projects, read the statement. The organization plans to work with an independent consultant to better understand their collective footprint and use 2022 as their baseline year. The statement added that Harry's sustainable tourism initiative, Travelist, and the investing firm Ethic, of which they are investors and impact partners, will advise the foundation on focusing its investments in support of a low-carbon economy. If that's not enough, Harry, he also signed on to join WAD's event for a panel on misinformation. According to the website, the Internet Lie Machine session, set for November 9, will examine what the real cost of a lie on the internet is, to ourselves, our communities, and our societies. The 95-year-old monarch was originally due to attend the COP26 summit in Glasgow but was forced to regretfully cancel her trip after receiving medical advice to remain in Windsor. Instead, a recorded video message was played to assembled delegates at an evening reception on November 1. Although the Queen will not be attending the summit following her recent health scare, but both the Prince of Wales and the Duke of Cambridge, alongside their two wives, were in attendance and had been photographed with world leaders such as US President Joe Biden and German Chancellor Angela Merkel. Both Charles and William have conducted a number of engagements throughout the week, which has included attending Stella McCartney's sustainable fashion show, meeting Earthshot Prize finalists, and hosting meetings with world leaders. The Duke of Sussex is also a passionate advocate for sustainability and the environment and has given several speeches on the matter both during his royal career and post-Megxit. During an interview with Oprah Winfrey for the Apple TV Plus series The Me You Can't See, he said, "With kids growing up in today's world, pretty depressing, right? Depending on where you live, your home country is either on fire, it's either underwater, houses or forests are being flattened.